Special lady.
Who are you singing first, time or second?
No, Harry, I'm singing second, man.
And a very exciting girl.
I'll bring that bass out, man.
Hey, man, I'll bring it out a little bit more.
You gotta be a special lady.
Let's get down on some harmony, come on.
Cause you got me sitting on top of the world. Sitting on top of the world.
Somehow I knew it would be you to change my gray skies to blue. And it was strange when you called my name. Ever since that day, I haven't been the same. Ooh, before I met you, my sun didn't want to shine. But all of a sudden, you slipped up from behind.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our guest of honor tonight, Susan Gisello Porter Coy, celebrating 50 years. Come on, let's give it up. 50 years. Come on, let's show us some love. This is our night. Give it up, give it up. Yeah.
What do we do? When the DJ's playing our favorite groove,
we stand
to win
the whole night through.
And what do we do when we're all dressed up and in the mood?
We stand
to what a step us through. Why?
To party and have some fun.
What is it that can come and take away all your stress? Tell me.
Music.
Of all the questions you have passed my test. Happy people.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Keeps the world
yeah, turning.
Oh, yeah.
Turning.
I believe that happy people.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Keeps us all.
Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Father, as we have gathered in this place, Father, to honor Sister Susie for such a milestone as 50 years of life. Now, God, we ask right now, God, that you would continue to bless her. We ask, God, that you would bless her with 50 more years, God. We ask, Father God, that her best days are yet to come, God. We ask, Father God, that her best memories have yet to be unfolded. So God, renew her youth as the eagle, God. I pray, God, that you will continue to bless her with favor. I pray that you would loose long life and prosperity upon her life and let her best days have be yet to come. Now, God, as we prepare to take and break bread and to to take upon this food that you have prepared. We ask that you would bless it. We ask that you would sanctify it. We ask that you remove anything that could be harmful for our bodies. And oh God, we ask that you would just let your grace and your spirit rest in this place, even as we celebrate, even as we're about to eat. In Jesus' name, we pray. Thank God. Let all those who love God say, amen.
Amen.
Love, word that comes and goes, but few people really know what it means to really love somebody. Oh, love, though the tears may fade away, I'm so glad your love will stay. 'Cause I love you, and you show me Jesus, what it really means to love. Oh, love, word that comes and goes, but few people really know what it means to really love somebody. Love, though the tears may fade away, I'm so glad your love will stay. 'Cause I love you, and you show me Jesus, what it really means. Oh, what it really means. Yeah, what it really means to love. The nights that I cry, you love me. When I should hang down, you love me.
But I just wanted to take a few minutes just to
let's all know, first of all, why we're here today. We're here today. No tissue boxes anywhere. We're here today because I just wanted to use my 50th birthday as a way to thank you. Thank you for being the important people that you are in my life today, yesterday, and I'm sure still tomorrow. I love you guys. You've all been with me through a whole lot. And I just wanted to use today not to celebrate me, but to celebrate you, and you, and you, and you, you, and you too. Oh my God. I thought about it. I said, okay, I'm gonna prepare a speech. And then I said, you know what? No, I'm gonna find a way to thank everybody somehow individually. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna work backwards. I'm gonna work with the people who had just come into my life. And that is my Mercer County family at the courthouse. I'm gonna give them a round of applause. I love them. Yes. They are a new team for me. I've been with them for about 3 to 5 years. I have my Mercer County family, court family, but these young ladies make every day a pleasure to go to work. These ladies, the gentlemen there, I love you guys so much. You support me every single morning, noon, and night, and I appreciate you. Then I have my Bronx County family. Roxy Lee, her family, there's so many I'm not even gonna begin to try to name. I love them so much. They've supported me through life and death and all kinds of stuff that I've had to go through and been through. And I love you all so much. Then I have my Rodriguez family. I've been with them since what, 1996?
Long time ago. Yeah.
When they moved into Pemberton and we become the best of friends, we are like family. We truly have lived and experienced life and death together. And I want you guys to know that I love them so much. I love you guys. Then I have my New York crew. I've got Shakur and Mark, Pam and Derek. Where's Cameron and who aren't here yet? Pam and Derek weren't here yet. And they have been rolling with me since Gwen and Albie, and they're not here. But since they were, well, these, my granddaughters' ages. And I have just enjoyed them. They have been my family. They are my rocks. Thank you so much, guys, for coming out. Yes, 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 yes. Then I have my Trenton family, my sister's family, Francis, Molly, Amy, and everyone, even those who aren't here yet. I love you guys. You're my sister's friends, you're my friends, and now we are family. And I love you guys so much. I just appreciate you all for being here. And as always, coming to everything, and we're always together going out and doing stuff, and I love you guys so much. Another family who is my everything. They are my surrogate family. They are the father-in-law and the father that I couldn't have because my own father-in-law, you know, was so many miles away. My own dad had passed. I love this family so much, and they are the Gilliards. I love you guys so much. This is my sister, my brother, my mother, my father. I love them. Thank you guys so much for everything you've done for me. You've been there with me. Like I said the other day, through thick and thin, all in. Another person who's been a big part of my life for a long time is Darren Jones. That's my bro. That's one of my BF.
Where the BF?
Yeah. Darren's is he's a brother to me. He has been there when Gwenny had every single one of our kids. He's always calling, checking on us, doing everything he can to make sure that, like a brother would, that I'm good. And I love you for that, Jarvis. Thank you. Another person, Mr. Don Howell. Hi, Don. Everybody give Don a round of applause. I appreciate you, Don. I know I don't say it often. Maybe I should. But I know I don't say it often, but I do appreciate what you have done for me and how you've been there for me through some of my worst times and my best times. And I love you and appreciate you for that. Now, another person who's been, another family and person who's been in my life since Gwen, Albie, me, their father, ever since we touched down here in Pemberton, and that's Karen Carter. Karen, I love you. Karen is there with me. We raised kids together. We worked together. We played together. And I love and appreciate you so much. I love your family, your mom, your kids. I just love you guys so much. And thank you so much for what you helped me with here today. And I just want to tell you, I love you so much, Karen.
Right back at
you. Another family, another person who's been an important part of my life. Jerome. Hi, Jerome. We raised kids together. We were together for 5, 6 years. We raised those kids the best way we could, and we did it. The kids love you. They love yours love me. I love them, and so on and so forth. And I just want to tell you that I tell you all the time how much I love and appreciate you, but I want to take today to tell you that everything you did for me, Gwen and Albie, I so appreciate it. I appreciate it. I love you for it. I just want to thank you. DJ, I love you. And then taking it back still a little further, the first family that when we moved here in 1982 or 3 months, was it? That we met, and they were our neighbors. This set of neighbors have been so important to me, and that is Mr. George Bulla. Please give them a round of applause. They were not only my neighbors, they were my friends, they were the parents, the extra set of eyes that parents had that watched over me and Albie when we lived there, you know. And I just want you to know that I've always appreciated you. I can tell you, I think I gave everyone when I said hello and smiled and wish you happy days and Merry Christmas and stuff like that. But I wanted to take today to let you all know that I love and appreciate you. And with that, Hoochie and Karen and Pam and everyone. Yolanda, excuse me, she's just Yolanda. See, that's how far back we go. I want you guys to know that I love you. I love you. And it was through you all that I met Arlene. Arlene and her husband. Yay. Thank you, Arlene. I'm not going to say everything. I love you, Arlene. But again, I wanted to take today to say thank you. Thank you so much to each and every one of you and your families. Then going back in time a little further, is Mr. Bill Mays. Hi, Bill. I love you. My dad passed over 27 years ago, and Bill has been in our lives for a long time.
He has been there
through thick and through thin with us, and I appreciate you. I love you because you love me, and I know you love my mom. And you guys are just wonderful. I thank you so much, Bill. And then I want to thank today my own family. before I get on y'all nerves. But I just want to tell you guys so much. To my surrogate sister, Tori Lynn Philippon, raise your hands for everybody seeing the car. And my girl Angie Blaylock, Angie and Nadine flew over 1,000 miles here also to come and be with us today. Thank you guys. Give them a round of applause. I love you guys. You've been rolling for so long. Kathy, I'm going to tell you, I love you so much. And you know what? I'm going to tell you, when Kathy left home, that's my older sister, for those who don't know, that's my older sister. When you left home, and we grew up and you left home, I was so lost without you. I was like, who gonna teach me the latest day and stuff? Thank you so much. And Kathy, I love you. You too flew 1,000 miles to get here to be with me today. To tell me happy birthday. And I just want to tell you that I love you. Sybil, my baby Sybil. You get on my nerves too sometimes. But I love you to death. I love you, okay? And I know sometimes I'm accused of being controlling with them all. And I'm accused of being mean to them all. And I am. But if, you know what? It's because I love you. I love you so much. And these are my granddaughters, and I love them to death. Let me just share with you all who don't know. My daughter Gwen today gave birth to her baby boy. So I love you. I love you. I wish you were here with us today. If everybody who knows me and Gwen know, we had some knockdown drag outs. But I love that girl. I love you, Gwen. I wish you were here. I realized when I was getting dressed today and getting ready that I didn't have my little part. But at least I know you're safe and sound with the baby. And I love you, Brittany, and I'll talk to you when you get out of the hospital. But last but not least, well, before I go to that person, let me just say Calvin. Calvin is the kid's father. And give him a round of applause, God, because he is father. And even though he's my father, he is every day. I love you, Calvin. Okay, I love you, and continue taking care of them babies. I love you, okay? And in walks another very important person in my life, and the person who's been in my life for so many years, and I love her, and that is my mother-in-law, Elizabeth Brenda Floyd. Everyone, please give her a round of applause. That's my mother-in-law. I love you. I loved her the day that Alan took me home to meet his mom. I thought that was so special. But then when I met her, I realized how special a day it was. But she is a very, very beautiful woman. I love you, Grandma. Mom, Lily, all those names. I love you so much. Along with Uncle Eddie and Aunt Ernestine. Those are my husband's aunt and uncle. But like I said, they are my family and I love them so much. And for so many years, they've been so good to me, so supportive of me. And what I would say is so many people that have in-laws would only wish that they could have as beautiful a set of in-laws that I have. Please give them a round of applause. I love you guys, and this is why we're here today, to tell you how much I love you. But one of the other person I want to thank today, and that is the person who has been with me for over 40, 50 years. This woman came to the United States, and she raised these kids, was married, and did everything that a mother is supposed to do. I love her so much. She's been with me through so much. And I just want to tell you, I love you so much, Mommy. But I just wanted to tell you that I love you so much. Before we leave, I do want to just acknowledge the people who couldn't be with us here today. I think I'd be a little remiss if I ignored, if I didn't mention them. And that is my Illinois family, no matter where they have moved to, my Illinois family that couldn't be here. I love you guys, I miss you. I love my family from Germany. I know so many of them wish that they could have been here today. I love you guys, the Garen and Fisher family. I love you guys, I miss you. But I just want to tell you too, thank you so much for having been in my life. And then the other people that couldn't be here, that would be in the order in which they were, that God put them in my life, I'll talk to them about in the order that he took them out. And that is my best friend, Eugene Jackson. May God rest his soul. Please give him a round of applause. If he were here today, God has called him home, but he wouldn't be here if he were, if he had an opportunity. The second person, my son, Alvin. I love you, Alvin. I know he too. My husband, Glenn Allen Cloyd. I love you. I know he too. And he were here, he would be here. And then my father, William James Porter. My rock. My second half, probably other half. I love them. So, I'm sorry if I kind of rambled on today. I hope that I got every single one of you. And I love you all so much. I cannot tell you enough how much I love and appreciate you. Like I said, we're here today to celebrate my birthday, but in actuality, I'm celebrating each and every one of you and everything and for all you've been in my life all these years. So, please continue to eating, and we're going to continue to have a party. Thank you, everyone.
Happy birthday, love you.
Thank you, family. Marriage, my very one and Susie's sisters. We came all the way from Peoria, Illinois to be here. Thank you. We are so glad to party with this woman. We've been partying with her since Thursday. I'm having a great time. Susie, we love you and continue to have many more birthdays.
Hello, everybody. I'm the big one, the oldest one, the one that came first. Then there came Susie. I think back when we were little, you know, my sisters always liked to play with dolls, and I liked to play with trucks and cars. I was a tomboy. So I used to take their dolls and pull their heads off and run them over my little cars, with my cars and everything. I was kind of mean to when we was little. But I'd have them cry, you know, and I would never let them in my room. I had my own room, so I was the oldest. But I love my sister. I will always love her. I will always gonna love you. I mean, I just don't know what I would do without my sister. You're like an extension. If you were something to happen to you, it would be something happening to me. I always can feel things, even though we're so far away. And I call her on the phone, I'll be like, what's going on? And she'll tell me, and I'm like, I knew something. I knew it, I just felt it. You know, sisters have this bond that it just can't be broken. I don't care what you do, who comes to your life, who your man is, or whatever. Nobody can replace or take that bond that you have with your sister. And we always gonna have that till the Lord calls us home. I just wanna say I love you, sister. Always.
I wanna make a toast to Susie, who has been more than I can ever describe to my life. And to so many other people, she means so much. And I thank God for being here on her 50th birthday. And I pray that 30 years from now, we'll be doing the same thing someplace else, celebrating what I'm sure is your 110. We'll be together doing it nonetheless. So, to Susie, salute.
Oh,
know when we talked, you said you wanted something inspirational, so I'm gonna just sing a song for you real quick. It's called Thank You Lord for All You've Done for Me. And it's really just a song that's a testimony that I'm gonna sing for you real quick. Tragedies are commonplace, all kinds of diseases. People are slipping away, economies down, people can't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Oh, tragedies are commonplace, all kinds of diseases. People are slipping away, the economy's down, people can't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. It could have been me outdoors with no food or no clothes, all left alone without a friend or just another number with a tragic end. But you didn't see fit to let none of these things be. And every day by your power, Lord, you keep on keeping me. And I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done. Oh, thank you, Lord, for all you've done. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.
You touch up. Our hearts tell us something.